Every time I read the name of one of our boys who lost his life, I have great admiration for them.
They defend our progressive ideas that will free our country from religious superstitions.
What do you want from us?
For the gift.
I can see her now.
For the air we breathe.
Hi.
Hi.
It's so wonderful to meet you, the mayor of Fatima. Oh my goodness. Your performance, so riveting. How did you prepare for your role?
Well, the whole story is biographical. It's a real story. So Arturo de Santos was a real character. There is many articles about him through the history books, and you know about Fatima. And I was reading as much as I could about him and about the time in Portugal, which was a really weird time, and why was he doing what he was doing. And so it was really interesting, you know, to study all of that. You know, it was a really, really interesting time in Portugal.
Sure. Producer Rose Gangusa has said that these children, you know, actually have become saints in Portugal, and it would have been really easy to just portray them as that. But the script and the belief was to go ahead and really tell the real story, how it was back in 1917. The children were treated with skepticism. And you as the mayor, you didn't believe them. Why do you think this is a better sort of route to go with the movie?
Well, I mean, all of us were kids when, you know, before they were saints, they were just kids. They were just doing kids stuff. And one day they saw this lady showed up in front of them, and she told them, look, guys, I want you to come here once a month. I want to give you this message. I think it's a really beautiful message and it's important. I would like for people to hear what I have to say. Sure. And they're like, okay, yeah, the lady was really nice. You know, she was cool. She was cute. She didn't say anything bad. Everything that she said was very loving and beautiful. So why mistrust her? So when kids start talking about that, they go from that perspective, nothing else, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
But the adults are the ones who are creating the turmoil and everything. The politics come into play. Portugal at the time doesn't like church, distrusts church. Portugal's government is trying to brand churchgoers as basically uneducated bunch who are just against science, against the new things, you know, technology and everything like that.
Sure.
And they're trying to get out the First World War. One of the reasons, you know, Portugal was never part of the Second World War because they got so hurt in the First World War. So it's a very, very difficult time in Portugal at the time. So the church doesn't want to accept the story from the kids because they know government's going to oppress them even more. So all these people are going against these poor kids, but the kids are just going through the storm of these adults, and they're just giving the message of this lady who was really nice to them, you know? So exactly. It's a really beautiful story. It's coming from a really clean and beautiful place of naive and very place of goodness from these kids, you know?
I think you just answered my next question.
Oh, I'm sorry. I tend to do that. I like to have these monologues.
That's wonderful. What do you feel is the heart of Fatima?
Well, I always like to, you know, people like to, when I tell them what the movie is about, you know, everybody's asking me, oh, so do you believe it? You know, do you believe in that miracle that it really happened? I'm like, well, it really doesn't matter. I mean, how are you gonna dissect it scientifically? Okay, let's say we have a video of that day of the miracle. You're gonna, one person, that's a CGI, that never happened. You know, this guy's gonna say, oh my God, it really happened. When you start scientifically dissecting it, you know, you lose faith. what I like to think in this movie is the message that these kids are putting out. You know, it's a message of love. It's a message of, you know, we need to love each other more. We need to pray more. And that's the message of the film, you know?
Oh, that's beautiful. Thank you for that.
It is a sin making lies up.
It's true, Mama. She was as real as you are.
Why would the Mother of God choose you? What's so special about you?
It could have been the devil.
He often disguises himself.
I've come for this year.
Hello, Stephanie Gil. It is so wonderful to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I just loved your performance in Fatima. It's just such a beautiful movie. And you play the oldest girl of your three cousins who is visited by the Virgin Mary in 1917, such a long time ago. How did you prepare for your role?
Well, first, when I got chosen, I went straight to Marco, obviously the director, and I asked him how he wanted to film it and from what point of view and how he wanted to make Lucia. Because obviously I was like 2020 Stephanie and I had to move to 1917 Lucia, you know, so I had to change everything about me. And it was really fun, the process. And I just prepared by reading the story again, reading how Lucia would be the character, strong, you know, brave, and from then we just went on to filming.
Sure. And I believe you were just 13, so young when you started this.
You were 12.
Oh my goodness. Wow. So I was wondering, your Lucia Moniz, who plays your mother, you know, you're in the film. Did she give you any advice?
Yeah, she was absolutely amazing, honestly. In the film, our relationship isn't really good at the beginning, obviously. But in real life, she's such a sweetheart, amazing actress, and she gave me so many tips and tricks when we were filming. And it was just so amazing filming with her. She's great.
Oh, that's wonderful. It's always good to have somebody in your corner, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's really great. Your character, she really is the focal, I believe, of the film. For all young people, particularly young girls, as Lucia, she needs to find strength to be strong in her convictions and her story. I was just wondering how you, your personal life, relate to her, and do you feel it's important for her story to be told?
Yes, I feel like in the first question you said about relating, I feel like we both have this inner world going on in our minds. There are some scenes in the movie where Lucia just sits down and to process and analyze everything that's happening to her. And just, I think those moments of, you know, faith and hope are what kept her going. And I have those moments too of, you know, thinking. And the second question about, what was it? About how children would relate?
Yeah. Especially for young girls nowadays, do you feel it's really important to show strength in a character? I know I'm loving the new Disney characters that are strong girls,
yeah. Women. It's super important that they learn that you should just be yourself and be brave and strong through anything that may happen to you, and never give up if you believe in something. Don't let others, you know, put you down because of that. You just need to keep going, you know?
Sure, absolutely. Especially in that scene when you're, oh my gosh, you're taken to the mayor's office and they're telling you, you know, those three kids, and it's like, oh my gosh, you know, this could all be over if you just change your story. And
no.
Yeah, you're like, no way. I applaud that. I think that's a beautiful role model that you're setting.
We came to see our children.
I want my child is dead!
This going to end.
All you need to say now is, I made everything up.
So sorry you couldn't see her.
It is so wonderful to meet you.
Oh, thank you so much, Sarah. It's Sarah is my sister's name.
Oh, that's so great.
It's always very. I love when I meet someone named Sarah because it gives me some. I don't know. It's just a connection. To meet you, Sarah.
Thank you for that. I feel that you had a difficult role to play. You play a mom who's doubting, yet she loves her child. I mean, that had to be just heart-wrenching. What were the challenges of that role?
Yes, it was a big, big challenge. I'm a mother. I have a daughter. She's 16 years old, and I never doubted my daughter. So thinking of a mother that doubts her daughter and doesn't believe in her and actually turns her back to her in a way, it was very tough to try to understand this behavior. Fortunately, I had a lot of material to read about it, from memories of Lucia with her mother, sure. And also some documents of studies and research that were done specifically about their relationship, which was very, very interesting and very helpful for me to understand this person, because to play this mother, I had to in a way forgive this this mother and understand her point of view, even though I didn't agree with it.
Yes.
But it was a big challenge. That was the biggest challenge for me, actually, was to play and represent this kind of mother. And my hope is actually to, through this film and through this story and through this character, to show that mothers and or fathers or whoever takes care of a child has to be aware and pay attention to what they feel, what they go through, and no matter what beliefs or whatever the subject is, we have to be on their side and be for them.
Thank you for that. How did you and Stephanie Gil, who does play your daughter, how did you create this natural closeness? Because there are some scenes, it's like they're so riveting and so real.
Oh, it always brings tears to my eyes when you speak. It was a very, very special connection. And it had to be quick. Because she came from Madrid. And the day I met her was the day that we started rehearsing. And most of the scenes are so, there's so much conflict between us. And she doesn't, and I'm tough with her. And then she's, so I was a bit uncomfortable with that. And it bothered me inside. That I didn't have the time to spend to be with her and get to know her and build and get this bond happening. So we took care of that really quick. Two days later, we went for sushi, we went for dinner, and her parents were amazing. They were really, really supportive. So we got along really quickly, and I'm so glad you say that you see that in the film, because we really connected and we still keep in touch. I went to Madrid already to visit her. She's a beautiful woman now, little woman.
it
was very special, very, very difficult, because we had very difficult scenes to play, but the trust was there, the bond was built, so that was very, very special.
Oh, thank you so much for that. What a thrill to have Andre Bocelli sing the song.
Yeah. I know.
Full of grace, and you are a singer and performer yourself. What do you feel having him involved with his brings to the movie itself?
I think when you understand that the music is there for more than just the music, and you see the way Bocelli is involved in it, and the way he's singing the song, and the way he's involved in the theme in general, it's clear that he really wants to be part of it, and it makes sense for him to do it, not just perform a song. So I think that's very powerful, and it jumps out of the screen in a way, you know.
Oh, exactly. I mean, I love that song. I'm already going to download it. It's just so beautiful. It brings tears to my eyes.
Faith begins at the edges of understanding.